There is a place where the lost embers go. As their light begins to fade, Emperor. The wall glistened. The painting showed embers on a sacred journey. Ember felt so afraid and alone that it was a relief to find someone to talk to. Ember froze, almost too frightened to look away, when they noticed a small satchel. Felt heavy. Ember looked inside. The statue shone brightly in the light. There was a symbol on the floor. There was a symbol on the floor. Ember noticed something wrong. There was a round space where something used to fit. To Ember's delight, the golden statue slid perfectly into place. Ember left, feeling sorry for the stranger now alone in the dark. The stairway opened into a dark forest. Ember could feel fear taking over. They'd washed up alone, somewhere very unfamiliar. Thank you. people felt like they were being watched. The only reply was silence. The path was blocked. As Ember approached, the flames seemed to call out. With a feeling like falling, the forest had slipped away. Ember felt lost in darkness and ruin. Caged flame stoked new hope in Ember. Hope was almost within reach. The flame spoke and Ember listened. The flame lingered ahead. Was it trying to escape? Or leading the way? Campfire flickered into life. The ghost spoke. Hope has returned to a forlorn. I will warm them until they choose to move on to the ghost for answers. This is a place between places. To travel through as your light fades. But none have passed on in a long time. The Forest King now holds us here. And those who linger will turn forlorn. Again, that word, forlorn. The forlorn are those who lost their way along the path. If you find them, send them to me and I will guide them. I am just a guide along the way to fan the flame. So many lost embers have I seen, more than I could help. Ember thought of those they loved, those they'd left behind. There are others lost along their journey. Find them and I will guide them. Step backwards, little ember. Look behind. Upon a small grassy cliff rests a forlorn. The stranger said, take care of those you care about the most. The door was sealed shut. Barely visible through the murky water was the shadow of something hiding. and on a small pier with barely a sound, a lonely fisherman sat. The ember was curious. Where did you wake up? I'm headed for the crossroads. It's not far, I think. I've heard there's a nest there, a safe place. The ember was... I'm headed for the... I've heard there's a nest there, a safe place. The fisherman murmured quietly between sorrowful breaths. The fisherman murmured quietly between sorrowful breaths. The fisherman felt so useless. His former joys were hollow. Sitting out there every day by the pond, only the dark water to hear him talk. In that darkness, a glimmer flickered. A thought beating like a drum. A thought that went round and round. All started with a frog. Every day by the pond, a constant reminder. For a brief moment, the fisherman struggled to speak. He looked at Ember, hopeful. The fisherman spoke softly. There's a frog in that pond, a big one. Saw him grow from a tadpole. We were friends of a sort. Spent every day side by side. So much better at fishing than me, that frog is. Catches them before I can bait them. Oh, it makes me feel useless some days. The fisherman sighed. I've wasted so much time feeling like this. The old man looked carefully at the pond, at their rod, at Ember. Well, listen to me here, rambling on and on. It helps, though, telling someone. Thank you, Ember. If you need help catching anything, you just ask. Poor little worms. They didn't ask to be here. But how do you fish without them? One for me, one for the fishes. Slurp them down. You saw the frog? Did the frog mention me? You ask the frog about me, see what they say. Actually, no, just... Please don't tell the frog how much I talk about them. They say catching a fish isn't the point. So I tell myself that. I tell myself that a lot. I chased old Blue Betty round this pond for years. Best days of my life catching that fish. Had to use myself as bait. Stuck on me head ever since. If you need help catching anything, you just ask. The frog stared at Embo, its belly rumbling. Its eyes were fixed on Embo, but it seemed to mean no harm. Was this the frog that the fisherman spoke of? Embo could hardly ignore the rumbling from the frog's belly. The frog stared at Embo, its belly rumbling. The traveler spoke. You ever had roast frog, friend? I miss a good roast frog. Oh, how they crackle. The stranger had been forgotten. They tried to follow as best they could. But no one heard them when they fell behind. Thank you. The stranger looked at Ember with surprise. Someone came back for me. Thank you. The stranger looked at Ember with surprise. Someone came back for me. Thank you. The traveler spoke. I miss a good roast frog. Oh, how they crackle. The old gate was locked. The crow held its shining trophy tight. The stranger whispered, "Ever feel like you are being watched? I've never felt that. What does it feel like? Is it nice? It sounds nice." key was nestled between the reeds. But it was just out of reach. The worm looked helpless, with no way to escape. As Ember picked it up, the worm let out a little yelp. Inside was a scrap of journal. The strangers on the water went on without me. Where have I landed? Vines and thorns stretch out to trip me. The stranger whispered. Ever feel like you are being watched? I've never felt that. What does it feel like? Is it nice? It sounds nice. The key was nestled between the reeds, but it was just out of reach. It didn't seem like that would really help. The Wanderer's Diary. Unfamiliar trees, a path overgrown. Is this a resting place? A place between places? I call out, but mine is the only voice. The frog stared at Embo, its belly rumbling. This was not how Embo had imagined the end. The gurgling of water, a deafening heartbeat. But then... the fog returned Ember's good deed by leading them to a lost forlorn. The stranger stood alone. Their friends have fallen aside. Retreating from what came next. The stranger had ventured on. Now they were deep in the woods. It felt so pointless. The stranger spoke hesitantly. Is the campfire crowded? Let me gather myself. I'll see you there.